number 24. How do we apply chain rule to these problems that actually you saw already in part one? So you will see our next test, we have more application problems probably.
Actually, I even wrote it like
what do I need here? I need another quantity. What are the sides are changing, right? What are we given? Ds, dt, right? Changing with time is what? 0.1 foot per hour, right? What else are we given? D theta dt is how much? 2 degrees per hour. Do we ever use degrees when we do calculation?
Never.
Never. So therefore we have to convert this to what?
Radius.
Radius. What's 2 degrees?
145.
You multiply by pi over 180, so it's pi over 90 radians per hour, right? Back in the good old days of calculus 1, you'd never wanted to have two variables like this, right? You had to relate them somehow. Also, what are we looking for? So these are the givens, right? Did I write all the givens?
Yeah.
What are we trying to find? Read the problem. Oh yeah, it brings me back to the test. Number 10 was really, really easy if you just knew how to read. Right? Number 10, but people give up. The lesson I was trying to teach you there is do not run away from a problem just because it looks hard. Because it, as Ethan said, it was probably the easiest problem.
It's
differentiation. Okay? Anyway, you might want to give it a try. Read it. So we have to learn how to read. What are we looking for? Find the rate at which the area of the triangle is increasing. So there's an area, right? So we want dA, let's call the area A, right? Find dA dt when what? dA dt when S is 20, right? Feet. And theta is 60 degrees, which probably we should convert to
pi
over 3. Isn't that how you did related race problem? You drew a picture, you jotted down the information you know, then you have to jot down what you want to find. If we're interested in the ADD, so the area of course is a function of the side, all the sides and the included angle, right? How do you find the area of an isosceles triangle? Did you understand why I drew it like this instead of like that? Because I said, why do I have to draw it sideways?
Oh, because we want to be able to find the height.
Yeah. I actually learned this from my son because I kept drawing it like this and I was... You can draw it like this, right? Because don't you... What am I looking for? I need the height, right? And if that's the theta, can I figure out that red height?
Yeah.
Opposite times what function of theta? S? Isn't this red thing S sine theta? Is that right? It's S sine theta. Therefore, can I write a formula for A involving S and theta? 1/2 base times height, right? What is the base? S. What is the height? S sine theta, so isn't the formula S squared, right? Sine theta. You get it. And we're not in, we're okay because we have, we know information about these two, right? So let's see, we want to, are we ready to do it? We want to find dA dt, right? Do we need to do a tree or you guys are okay? If you want, we can do a tree. Maybe that helps us. It's very comforting, right? A is a function of what? S and theta. And these, in turn, are functions of time. I think maybe it helps to have that. Isn't the tree very nice?
I
have
that tree.
Instead of like messing with your... Okay, so what is the ADT? It's the partial of A with respect to S, multiplied by ds dt, very good, plus the partial of A with respect to theta, multiplied by d theta dt. Yeah, I think I'm loving the tree also. Okay, alright, so what is the partial of A with respect to S? Just S, right? Times what? Isn't S sine theta, right? Okay? Times ds dt, leave it first, right? Because we're just doing it in general. Plus, what's the partial of A with respect to theta? 1/2 s squared, correct? Cosine theta, right? Followed by d theta dt. Are we ready to plug in our special values? So now what do we do? We want to find the ADT when s is 20, theta is pi over 3. What else? What other information do I need? Plus all those, well, then we just need to plug in the givens, right? This is the specific instant of time, right? But these are for givens happening all the time. So those two, okay? So therefore, the answer to our problem is the ADT is equal to what? S is 20, sine of pi over 3, right? Ds dt we know is what? 0.1, let's forget the units for now, plus half 20 squared, right? Cosine of pi over 3, d theta dt is pi over 9. Okay? And if you have the time, can I just give you the answer?
Sure.
The answer that I got, if I did this right, is around 5.22 cubic square feet per hour. Did you understand how to do this? In fact, is it important here to change this to pi over 3 at this point in the game?
No.
Could we have used 60 degrees? Where was it important though? I think this one is important, right? Because you need to make them real numbers.